بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. اللهم إني أسألك علما نافعا ورزقا طيبا وعملا متقبلا.
We will learn today about one of the Quranic surahs, and this surah is Surah Al-Humazah. These are some facts about Surah Al-Humazah. It located in the last part of the Quran, part number 30. It is 9 verses. Its number 104. Its name Al-Humazah, and it took from the noun Humazah, and it means slanderers or who speak ill or bad about someone in his absence. It located in page 601 of Quran book, and it revealed to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam while he was in Mecca. So this surah is Makkiya.
Repeat after me these verses of Surah Al-Humazah. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ويل لكل همزة لمزة. الذي جمع مالا وعدده. يحسب أن ماله أخلده. كلا لينبذن في الحطمة. وما أدراك ما الحطمة. نار الله الموقدة. التي تطلع على الأفئدة. إنها عليهم مؤصدة. في عمد ممددة. صدق الله العظيم. And now these are the vocabularies. ويلٌ وو, and it means a valley in the hellfire. همزة, slanderers or scorner, and it means those who speak ill or evil on people in their absence. لمزة, backbiters, and it means those who mention faults of people. وعدد, and counted it, and it refers to those people who collected their wealth and calculated it. أخلد, يحسب أن ما له أخلد, means make him last forever or immortal. Also means kept him alive so he never dies. لَيُنْبَذَنَّ will be thrown. And it means will be sent to the fire. Al-Hutama, the crushing fire. Or intense fire. And this one of the hellfire's names. Could you know another names for the hellfire? Search and tell. تَطَّلِعُ عَلَى الْأَفْئِدَةِ means leaps above the hearts. And also means with its heat reaching up to the hearts. مُؤْصَدَ إِنَّهَا عَلَيْهِمْ مُؤْصَدَ it shall be closed. And it means its doors, the doors of the hellfire, are locked upon those the bad people.
Now, learning objectives 3. Clarify the general meaning of Surat Al-Humazah. In Surat Al-Humazah, Allah, glory be to him, talks about three kinds of the bad people. The first one, slanderers, those who speak ill about others in their absence. The second, backbiters, those who mention others' faults. And greedy or stingy, those who like to collect money more without giving a little bar to poor and needy. ويل لكل همزة لمزة الذي جمع مالا وعدد همزة the slanderers لمزة backbiters الذي جمع مالا وعدد the stingy or the greedy يحسب أن ماله أخلد He think that his money or his wealth will let him live forever, and he is wrong in this matter because no one will live forever. كلا لينبذن في الحطمة Those bad people will join hellfire. كلا لينبذن في الحطمة وما أدراك ما الحطمة نار الله الموقدة الحطمة This one of hellfire's names. So Allah talks about those three types of the bad people if they didn't stop and repent to Allah they will enter hellfire especially Allah prepared to them a valley in the hellfire called Wail in the second part of Surah Al-Humazah Allah describes the hellfire by some qualities. Crusher will crush the body of the bad people. Clays or high heat and temperature. نار الله الموقدة التي تطلع طلعوا على الأفئدة means this fire is rich to their hearts and cover it till cover the whole their body. إنها عليهم مؤصدة means مؤصدة means it closed on them so no one can escape. في عمد مهددة the hellfire surrounded by columns and has gate and it closed and behind this gate there is the guardian of the hellfire. So in this verses Allah, glory be to him, teach us about these three types of the bad people in order to didn't follow them and behave others with good manners in order to be away from the fire and enter Jannah, inshallah.
And these are a creative and a challenging questions. Find out the three types of bad people who mentioned in the surah. Clarify how Allah described the hellfire in this surah. The first questions, Allah glory be to him, mentioned that he prepared a narrow valley in the hellfire for three types of the bad people. Those are scorners or slanderers, and those who talk badly about others in their absence. The second, mockers or backbiters, and those are who mention other faults. And the third, stingy or murderly, and those who love to collect the wealth and didn't give to the poor and needy, a little part. For the second question, Allah glory be to him described the hellfire as crushers. It will crush and destroy the body of the bad people, will burning them completely. It closed on them and surrounded by columns.
And this searching question, search for another names of hellfire. These are some names of hellfire that mentioned in the Holy Quran. Jahim, Jahannam, Lava, Sa'ir, Saqar, Hutama, and Hawiya. Now we reach to the values that we could learn from Surat Al-Humazah. The first value, polite. I should be polite when I treat others and when I talk with them. So I should not talk any bad or evil things about others in their absence. The second value, respect. I should respect others whatever their nationality or their countries and didn't talk about their faults. The third value, generosity. I should be generous and try as much as I can to help the poor and needy by giving them a little part of my money. Didn't like only to keep the money and collect it without trying to help the poor and needy by anything. And the last value, we
we could learn obey and thank Allah. I should obey Allah, glory be to Him, when He advises me in this surah, Surah Al-Humza, by giving up on these bad qualities, Humaza, slanderers, and backbiters, and stingy. And also, I should thank Allah about His blessings upon me by trying to help others, especially help the poor and needy.
Link with Hadith. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ليس المؤمن بالطعان ولا اللعان ولا الفاحش ولا البذيء رياض الصالحين. The Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم say the true believer doesn't taunt or curse or abuse or take indecently رياض الصالحين. This hadith means the true believer should not taunt, means mock others or make fun on others, curse, say bad dua on others, abuse, say bad words to others, talk indecently, means say impolite words to others. So, the link between this hadith and the title of our lesson about Surah Al-Humaza is both of them talk about bad qualities that the believer should not behave others with. Link with life and community. I should behave my classmates with good manners and also treat others in my community with good manners. My neighbors, my relatives, my parents, my brothers and sisters, also the workers or the salesmen with good manners, to be a good character and a good believer. In the end of our lesson, we should say this dua in the end of any lesson or meeting. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.
Thank you for watching and listening. See you in a new lesson.
Thank you for your watching and listening. See you in a new lesson. إن شاء الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.